I repeat, cried the Lorax, I speak for the trees. I'm busy, I told him, shut up if you please. I rush across the room, and in no time at all, built a radio phone, I put in a quick call. I called all my brothers and uncles and aunts, and I said, listen here, here's a wonderful chance for the whole Onceler family to get mighty rich. Get over here fast, take the road to North Mitch. And in no time at all, the factory I built, the whole Onceler family was working full tilt. We were all knitting thneeds, just as busy as bees, to the sound of the chopping of truffula trees. And oh baby oh, how my business did grow. Now chopping one tree at a time was too slow, so I quickly invented my super axe hacker, which whacked off four truffula trees just at one smacker. We were making thneeds four times as fast as before, and that Lorax, he didn't show up anymore. But the next week he knocked at my new office door with more of the words he had told me before. He snapped, I'm the Lorax who speaks for the trees, which you seem to be chopping as fast as you please. But I'm also in charge of the brown barbalutes who played in the shade in their barbalute suits. Now thanks to your hacking my trees to the ground, there are not enough truffula fruits to go around. And my poor barbalutes are all getting the crummies, because they have gas and no food in their tummies. They loved living here, but I can't let them stay. They'll have to find food, so I sent them away. Oh, the Onceler, I felt sad as I watched them all go. But business is business, and business must grow. I meant no harm, I truly did not. But I had to grow bigger, so bigger I got. I figured my factory and I figured my road. I biggered my wagons and I biggered my loads. Of the thneeds I shipped out, I was shipping them forth, to the south, to the east, to the west and the north. I went right on biggering and selling more thneeds, and I biggered my money, which everyone needs. Again he came back, I was fixing some pipes, when that old nuisance Lorax came back with more gripes. And the Lorax, he coughed and he whiffed, he sneezed and he snuffled, he snarled and sniffed. Oh Onceler, he cried with a cruffulous croak, oh Onceler, you're making such smogulous smoke. My poor swimmy swans, why they can't sing a note, 'cause no one can sing who has smog in his throat. And so, said the Lorax, please pardon my cough, they cannot live here, so I'm sending them off. Oh, where will they go? They may fly for a year, to escape from the smog you've smogged up around here. What's more, snapped the Lorax, his dander was up, let's say a few words about cluppity-clup. Your machinery chugs on day and night without stop, making cluppity-clup also schluppity-schlup. what do you do with this leftover goo? I'll show you, you dirty old once the man you. You're clumpy in the pond where the humming fish hummed. No more can they hum, for their gills are all gummed. So I'm sending them off, oh, their future is dreary. They'll walk on their fins and get woefully weary. In search of some water that isn't so smeary, with fins that are sore and with eyes that are bleary. And then I got mad, I got terribly mad, and I yelled at the Lorax, "Now listen here, Dad. Well, I have my rights, sir, and I'm telling you, I tend to go on doing just what I do. And for your information, you Lorax, I'm figuring on biggering and biggering and biggering and biggering, turning more truffle trees into thneeds, which everyone, everyone, everyone needs." And at that very moment, we heard a loud whack. From outside in the fields came a sickening smack of the axe on a tree, and we heard the tree fall, the very last truffle tree of them.